Hi everyone, welcome back to High School Science 101. Today we are making a vortex cannon, and it's a fun, simple, and cheap project you can make at home, especially now that it's the school holidays. Let's get started. Alright, to make one of these, what you need is some scissors, a balloon, I would recommend having a few of these, and a plastic cup, and we call these solo cups because they're a bit bigger than your normal cup. And you need a drill that has a special attachment that allows you to cut holes. So ask your parents about that and get them to do it for you because that bit's pretty dangerous. Once you have the hole cut out in the bottom of your cup, what you need to do is stretch a balloon over the wide end, the wide opening of the cup. And this gives us our membrane that we can flick or pull back and shoot our jets of air. This opening of the balloon isn't big enough to stretch over the wide opening of the cup. So what we need to do is cut the balloon about here, which gives us a wider and more stretchy opening, which will hopefully fit over the cup. Sometimes it doesn't, sometimes these rip, so it's good to have a few spare balloons just in case. Before we try to stretch the balloon over the cup, what I've done is inflated the balloon, which gives us some more elasticity. It's stretched the rubber a bit more and increases our chances of getting it over the rim of the cup without it tearing. So give it a good stretch before you actually cut into the balloon. And now I think we're good to start cutting it. And we are going to cut it about here, which gives us a wider opening than what we started with. And now the fun part is trying to stretch this opening of the balloon over the wide opening of the cup. And like I said before, often these balloons will tear. That's why it's really important to stretch them and really get them more malleable than what they start with. So let's have a go. And there we have it. We now have a balloon membrane that we can flick or pull back. So now let's test this on some targets. To make a basic target, all I've done is gotten a plastic container, stuck a hole in the top of it, and then stuck a straw through the hole, and I've sticky taped a tissue to the top of the straw. I would recommend using something a bit more sturdy than a straw though, like a paddle pop stick or a kebab stick, because the straw is pretty bendy and not really stable. But now you've got a really lightweight target that stands up, and you can then shoot it with your vortex cannon. And to shoot it, you can flick it, but you get a better effect by pinching the membrane, pulling it back, and letting go. And now cue some dramatic editing. So you might be thinking, well, that's kind of cool, but wouldn't it be good if you could see the air coming out of the cup? And the answer is you can if you've got a special piece of equipment. You need one of these. And when you fill the cup full of smoke, you can actually see what the air is doing as it leaves the cup. What you're looking for when you're doing this is for little rings to form when you flick it right in the middle of the membrane. And it takes a bit of practice to get it just right. Okay, now we're going to try
on a little bit bigger scale. That's it for today. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.